And the countdown continues. This is meat prepping. My word. So we have some chicken. Well, a whole chicken. And some liver and giblets for the stuffing. What's this? And you can't even remember what this is. I can't even remember. Oh, this is oxtail and beef for cook up. This is pork because we're going to bake some pork. We're going to do some garlic pork as well. And I think this is pork too. And something else. Oh, fish is in the freezer already clean because we went to the fisheries last week. Turn on the volume of the music, please. And we have some crab in the freezer. So we meat prepping tonight. Countdown to Christmas. Alright, step one, peel all of this garlic. Ugh. And then blend up my seasonings. Alright. Let me see if this works as they show on YouTube and these shorts and on TV. Oh. Okay. Haha, no, he doesn't. It's my wedding season. Strip some time. All right. I need to clean up some of this mess. So it's one through all of my garlic peels. What's this? All right, we add some fine thyme. Some salt. I personally like to put a little bit of mustard. Oh, ginger. Cause this one is for the chicken, so I'm gonna put a little bit of ginger. A little bit of ginger. A little extra something. Oh, I forgot. Just for some extra greenery. You got a little bit of green on you. Let's put a little bit. I already have a lot of onions in there. So these are some green onions. Kayla girl, bring me a pen. Let me write down all I do so I can put it in the description. Uh-huh. Not that I need it, the blender will do the work. Add a little water. Alright. This is the one for the chicken. Looks like a smoothie, right? Yeah, it's a little chunky. That's good. This is the one for. There we go. Got a little bit of seasoning pieces in it. But this is the one for the chicken. Let's move on to the one for the pork. This is the thyme and the garlic now for the pork. Pork is going to be a little different. It's going to be minus the green onions and the ginger. But an increase of pepper because we want it spicy. So it's going to be a nice spicy kind of jerk. Pork, I don't know, jerk is a method of cooking or it's a seasoning actually. So yeah, it's going to be jerk pork so to speak. Guyanese style. Let it not be confused with the Jamaican thing, eh? This is Guyanese Deblin style. Jerked pork. So it's going to be hot and spicy. So I'm adding my thyme. Come add the thyme to it, Gabby. Wait. Alright, I have a helper. So Add the thyme to the blender. All of it. Try and get them inside. And this is, while she's doing that, this is some wiri peppers. Now, I don't know what's the heat index on this, according to the Scoville scale that they use to measure the heat in chili peppers, but I know it's hot. I was thinking 4, maybe I'll do 3. I'll do 3, because the children like pork, so this will deter them from eating a whole lot. They'll just get to taste it. So we'll do 3, see how the heat goes. If it burns our nose, then maybe not. Let me see how it goes. So I have garlic, fine leaf thyme, and 3 wiri peppers. While this carries quite a heat, it has a nice flavor to it. Like the tortolan seasoning peppers has a nice flavor without the heat. This has heat and flavor. Actually, some tolan seasoning peppers would be good in this. Hey, a tolan, hook me up with some seeds. All right, there we go. Now we're going to add some salt. I'll hold your hand. So wait. I have to help you control the salt. Wait, girl. Slow down. Hey, we jam in there.
Mommy, I could help
you. You want to help?
You can.
You have to wash your hands and come back.
I was just about to say.
Let's go. Blend. Careful. No. Turn it, ensure it fits. You're just about to break my blender, girl. Stop.
Blend some more, mommy.
Blend, Sammy. Blend. Alright, this is a green, this looks like a green smoothie, but it smells delicious. So yeah, the pork will be on and popping. Wanna see? Smells good, right? Come smell it.
Smells like
golden apples. Oh, it smells like golden apples. You know, that's the idea. I should have put... This is my seasoning blend for the chicken. Onion, garlic, thyme, ginger, pepper, a little bit of mustard and salt. And this one is for the pork. Lots of thyme, lots of pepper and garlic. And this one is for the garlic pork. This is a baked pork. This one is for garlic pork. The garlic cut up at the bottom with some thyme and some peppers. And then we pickle it with some vinegar salt. All right, on to cleaning of the meat. We gonna clean the bird. This is some white vinegar to cut the rank and get rid of the slime. That's vinegar. Clean the chicken. Thank you. All right. Oh, live and giblets time.
What kind of oven is the pizza? Oh.
Why don't put some seasoning
in?
All right. Let's get the fat off. I was just pulling the fat off. This is... Hey, nothing goes to waste.
Huh?
All right, this is what, the second or third rinse. We put some bigger every day, we getting bigger. I just put some lemon just to cut it, cut the rank. I don't want it too strong and overpowering. Aha. Smelling nice. Smelling good. Lemony. Not strong lemon, but mild enough to cut the rank. See, the liver start breaking down from just a little piece of lemon skin. It's already break down the liver. All right, season this. Hey, a little bit of mustard. A little bit of mustard. A little bit of adobo. And you hook up this liver. Done. I am separating the liver from the gizzard now. Oh, lemon. Liver from the gizzard now so that on cook day. I don't have to do that. It's just, see all this goodness right here? We will not waste. Look what you do now. You see all this goodness? No, you don't throw this away. I gotta put it in the angle so you can see. Add this to my bag, helps with the marinating. Woo! Yes, sir. All the goodness is there. Ah. Aye, aye. No, look, no. This is what you do. If you're a guy, if you're a true Guyanese, a true Caribbean person, nothing goes to waste. Yes, sir. This here, put some right here, too. We're getting bigger every day. And I will tie these two bags together because they will be cooking on the same day. Boom. I know on YouTube people do unboxing. I am unbagging. I have a whole pork leg. Oh my word. Woo. Look at this. Yeah. This will make my baking so much easier. Now I need to figure out how I'm getting all my seasoning all on the inside of this. Don't worry, this little sharp knife will talk for me. Yes, sir. Look at that. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. I can't remember the person have to wash off the... I'll be South American. I am armed and ready to tackle the pepperoni pork. Oh boy, this looks so good. And it smells good too.
Ooh.
Hope this up, Lord. No, we're missing a minute.
Mommy, I go to my glove and help you rub around.
Mommy, it smells so good. Cool. It smells like if you're cooking.
It smells
like. Yeah. Mommy, look at the skin. Look at all the skin. Yeah, look, Mommy, we have to stuff in some. Stuff some in.
Put the, get a syringe, put some in, and go.
That's the sound it makes. What to do with this thing, but Jesus, we go to the raisin popper. Alright, I survived. I survived the pig's head. I got as much meat as I could off of it. And here, score ribs. So we have ribs. I have a nice trotter for my pepper pot. And we have some parts from the head. I will use for my garlic pork. Oh yes, it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Yeah, yeah. All the pork is here. All right, I'm getting a little tired. So this is me working on the beef for the, this is me working on the beef. Wait, oh gosh, I have oxtail. This is me working on the beef for the pepper pot. I have some pork and thing in there. The trotters and the ears and some cut pieces of the pork. Hey, where you going? Beef.
Where's the beef, Mommy?
Alright, so we have the trotters, some oxtail, some pieces of pork ready to start the pepper pot, and then we'll add the rest as we go. This is beef for the pepper pot. Beef clean and seasoned ribs. A whole chicken. This is my gizzard and giblets for my stuffing. I have set my garlic pork and pork shoulder, is it? Pork somebody. But it's pig. So after all this hard work, we've been in it for about a couple of hours. 7 o'clock, I think somebody has started. But anyway, we've been at it for a few hours.
Hey, morning. So everybody's sleeping. And
This is the morning after we clean all the meat last night. So I had this brilliant idea. Start, you know, if the flavor's right. But them sleeping, so they know, don't. I'm going to eat garlic pork. It probably ain't fully set, but I just have the need to eat some garlic pork. See this here? You see this goodness at the bottom? And you get a piece of bread and you dab it in this here, boy. Ooh la la. You're good to go. So the bad news is, I had a super plan to eat my garlic pork. And then Ronald woke up, just as I came out. But the good news is, most of the army is still sleeping, so we have a moment. We have an early morning moment by ourselves for probably 10 minutes. We can enjoy the moment. We can eat garlic pork and crackers pre-breakfast with some warm water to start our stomachs off. And then we can have the meat and the meat.
Couple times. Keep you, the Lord cause his face to shine upon you, lift up his countenance upon you, be gracious unto you, and give you peace. Shalom.